Have you heard the terms food insecurity and housing instability? Can you code for these terms? And better yet, should you? Let's chat about it. Oh, and if you stay until the end, I will provide you some new ICD-10-CM diagnosis codes that are effective October 1st that you may find helpful. Hey there, and welcome. If you are new here, you don't know me yet. I'm Clarice Warner, the girl with the pearls, the founder and education director of the Professional Reimbursement Network, LLC, where coding education is key. And on this channel, I provide you with information, tips, and strategies on how to become a certified marketable medical coder. As a result of my straightforward strategies, tips, and optimistic approach to education and learning, I've served hundreds of students and helped them transform to become certified medical coders who have developed dynamic careers in the business of healthcare and are valuable resources in their own right. Consider subscribing to my channel to get the latest and greatest information and tips you need to become a certified marketable medical coder. And don't forget to hit the bell for notifications of my weekly videos. The dictionary tells us that a food insecurity is an economic and social condition of limited or uncertain access to adequate food. The definition of housing insecurity is a little more complex, and according to the Journals of General Internal Medicine and Community Psychology, if a person is having trouble with paying their rent, moving from place to place often, staying with friends and family, or spending the majority of their household money on housing, they may be considered housing insecure. Both of these terms are social determinants of health. I talked about the meaning of social determinants of health and the connection between the social determinants of health and health information in this video. Social determinants of health have been defined as conditions in the environment in which people who are born, live, learn, work, play, worship, and age that affect a wide range of health functioning and quality of life outcomes and risks. Recently, the American Health Information Management Association, or AHIMA, issued a policy statement on the social determinants of health. I have placed a link in the description box below for you to review. AHIMA states that by improving the capture, sharing, and use of social determinants of health, data could result in a number of benefits, including enhanced acute and chronic disease prevention, treatment, and health promotion. One of the challenges that must be overcome to realize the benefits of social determinants of health data include ethical collection and use of social determinants of health data. New approaches must expressly prohibit the use of social risk profiles or other information to be used for discriminatory purposes, stigmatization, implicit bias, or in decisions that limit care options, lead to poor outcomes, and exacerbate existing health inequities. It is a timely document with significant points, and I encourage you to be in the know and read it. I asked the question, should you code for social determinants of health? And the answer is, of course you should. The other question was, can you code for social determinants of health issues like food insecurity and housing instability? Well, with your ICD-10-CM Z codes, you can. Social determinants of health codes are located primarily in these Z categories: Z55, problems related to education and literacy; Z56, problems related to employment and unemployment. Z57, occupational exposure to risk factors. Z58, problems related to physical environments. Z59, problems related to housing and economic circumstances. Z60, problems related to social environment. Z62, problems related to upbringing. Z63, other problems related to primary support group, including family circumstances. Z64, problems related to certain psychosocial circumstances. Z65, problems related to other psychosocial circumstances. For 2022, not only do we have new social determinants of health Z codes, we also have revised guidance from the ICD-10-CM official guidelines for coding and reporting. In section 1.C.21.C.17, we find the following information. Revised guidelines for Z codes, the new social determinants of health section, 17 social determinants of health codes describing social determinants of health should be assigned when this information is documented. For social determinants of health, such as information found in categories Z55 through Z65, persons with potential health hazards related to socioeconomic and psychosocial circumstances, code assignment may be based on medical record documentation from clinicians involved in the care of the patient, who are not the patient's provider, since this information represents social information rather than medical diagnoses. For example, coding professionals may utilize documentation of social information from social workers, community health workers, case managers, or nurses if their documentation is included in the official medical record. Patient self-reported documentation may be used to assign codes for social determinants of health as long as the patient self-reported information is signed off by and incorporated into the medical record by either a clinician or provider. See section 1B.14, documentation by clinicians other than the patient's provider. Okay, now on to the new social determinants of health Z codes. Z55.5, less than a high school diploma. Z58.6, inadequate drinking water supply. Z59.00, homelessness unspecified. Z59.01, sheltered homelessness. Z59.02, unsheltered homelessness. Z59.41, food insecurity. Z59.48, other specified lack of adequate food. Z59.811, housing instability, housed with risk of homelessness. Z59.812, housing instability, housed homelessness in the past 12 months. Z59.819, housing instability, housed unspecified. Z59.89, other problems related to housing and economic circumstances. Hopefully, you have found information that helps you understand more about the importance of capturing social determinants of health with the ICD-10-CM Z codes. You have learned the meaning of food insecurity and housing instability. You have also learned their connection to social determinants of health and what's in store for 2022 related to coding for social determinants of health. Questions of the day. Does your organization report social determinants of health? What are your thoughts on AHIMA's policy statement on social determinants of health? Let me know in the comments. I would love to hear your thoughts. I'm Clarice Warner, the girl with the pearls, the founder and education director of the Professional Reimbursement Network, LLC, where coding education is key, providing you with information tips, and strategies on how to become a certified marketable medical coder. And if you are interested in more information on these tips and others on how to become a certified marketable medical coder, well then check out these videos and check this out.
Are you interested in medical coding, but not sure where to start and scared of wasting time and resources? Let me help you with the right steps to become a certified marketable medical coder. Learn more at bit.ly/5stepscoder.
If you liked the video, don't forget to let me know by hitting the thumbs up, hitting the subscribe button, and the notification bell so you are informed every week when I upload new content. Again, I love hearing from you, so let me know you were here by providing a comment or asking a question or just stopping by to say hi. You can also give me a little love by sharing this video on your social media platforms. Tag me in your video share at prncodingedu. Let's stay connected and connect others. If you want to learn more about the wonderful world of health information, medical coding, and or healthcare compliance, then watch one of these videos. Remember, be safe, be kind, and don't wish for it, work for it. Until next time, take care, and thanks so much for watching.